Hello guys, in this video we are starting the moment of inertia of continuous mass system. And in continuous mass system, the formula which we will use would be the moment of inertia I is equal to integration of dm into r square. This formula can easily be predicted by the fact that in discrete mass system we used summation, because summation is the addition of discrete functions, and in to add continuous functions we use integration. So to find out the moment of inertia of continuous mass system, we are using this formula I is equal to dm into r square. Now to demonstrate this formula, let us take an example and let us find out the moment of inertia of a uniform rod about an axis which is perpendicular to the rod, and this axis is also passing through the center of mass of the rod. Now let us consider a element, a small part of the rod, which has a length of dx and its distance from the axis of rotation is x. So the mass of this element is equal to dm, and dm is m upon l into dx. So this is the mass of this element, and the moment of inertia of this element about this axis is integration of dm into x square. So di, in fact, this is the moment of inertia of this small element. So the total moment of inertia of the system would be integration of dm into x square, and by substituting the value of dm, which is m by l into x square into dx, so the limit of x would be, see, while applying the limit of x we should be careful, and we should remember the fact that we have to cover up the complete rod, and the x is vanishing at this axis, which means the value of x is 0 at this axis. Now we have to figure out the complete rod, and therefore the value of x or the lower limit would start from this point, which is minus l by 2 to plus l by 2. So the limit would be minus l by 2 to plus l by 2. So I is equal to m by l, and the integration of x square is x cube by 3, and this is minus l by 2 to plus l by 2. So I is equal to m by 3l into, this is l cube by 8 minus plus l cube by 8. So I would be equal to m l square by 12. So this is the moment of inertia of the rod about an axis which is passing through its center of mass, and this axis is also perpendicular to the rod. And in further videos we would be calculating and we would be finding out the moment of inertia of different types of continuous objects. Thank you.